Scene of power, opportunity for blessing, time of change, we look forward to it. We will get answers by all means.
안진뱅이가 일어나고
The scene of the power, where the crippled can stand up, the deaf can hear, and the blind can see. Through the amazing works of power manifested by the senior pastor, we have been healed of various incurable diseases, as well as having our problems solved. I fell in a pit in 1993 when I was riding a bicycle. Since then, I could not turn my neck. My waist was herniated. So I used many drugs because I could not move my arms and shoulders. But the injury was not healed. At that time, I felt fire come upon my spine, waist, and neck as the senior pastor prayed for the sick on the altar. And fire came upon both of my knees and whole body. At that time, after I received prayer, I could bend from my waist naturally and turn my neck like this. Now, I'm so healthy. Hallelujah. I came to the Manmin Church in 1993 and got healed of a lump on my right hand. In 1995, I got healed of my blind left eye at a two consecutive week special revival meeting. In addition, the hearing ability of my both eyes was restored through the 2016 summer retreat. I long for the divine healing meeting. Divine healing meeting of healing, answer, and blessing. The time full of that touch will be unfolded again at today's second part of the Friday all-night service. I look forward to it so much. I'm waiting for it every day. I desire to have a lot of blessings and answers at the divine healing meeting. Truly, I want to see the shepherd, because I remember that we were filled with the Holy Spirit when the senior pastor was with us. We were filled with the Holy Spirit once again through the second part of the Friday all-night service in 2019. I'm grateful that we will become more and more enthusiastic than we already are. I had a desire of my heart for the divine healing meeting, so I harbored it as my prayer title. I think that many of our members will attend and receive grace, solve various problems and receive answers. When the shepherd led the divine healing meeting, my faith grew by witnessing the amazing power, wonders, and signs. In 2019, God will work in a newer and more amazing way. It means that God can work in any problem you might have. The problem is your faith. I mean, when you have no wall of sin between you and God. Therefore, in order to experience the work of God, you must first turn away from your sins, repent, and break down the sin barrier. Even though you do not live perfectly according to the Word of God from the beginning, if you pray diligently and try hard, God will give you the strength to live according to His Word. When you try to do this, God will be pleased to see. So He will give your heart a spiritual faith. We hope that you have an opportunity to receive answers, healing, and blessings through the Divine Healing Meeting at Friday All-Night Service for the last week of every month.
다음은 주간 단신입니다.
The following is news, weekly news. We will have the 27th graduation ceremony for the United Holiness Theological Seminary at 2 p.m. on January 31st. 'Once God has spoken, twice I have heard this, that power belongs to God.' In the beginning of this church, the senior pastor, though about how he could solve the many problems of beloved members, and the answer was power. The power of God who created all things by the word did not appear only in the beginning, but also in the Old Testament times and in the times of Jesus and his disciples. His power appears in the same way through proper people today. Our mummy members have always been like this for the last 37 years. We were not afraid and uncomfortable even if we had a big or small disease or encountered some difficulties due to our faults. We felt that if we had to repent, we repented and asked the senior pastor for prayer and would receive the answer and glorify God. Each time we could experience God more greatly than we do by only relying on our own faith. People who met the living God. Hi, I'm Brother Yashin Tong Kang Kawang from Thailand, Bangkok, Deaf People's Mumming Church. I became deaf when I was 3 years old. I played with sand on the beach, and accidentally the sand got into my ears. Next day, I went to the hospital because my ear was painful, and then the eardrum burst due to the sand in the ear. After that, I could not hear at all. Guided by my acquaintance, I visited Thailand Bangkok Mammin Deaf People's Church. I was so touched by the bright and gracious image of the worshiping members and the polite and neat appearance of the deaf members who came before God and offered the worship service around the world through the multi-webcam program. I also watched on the internet the overseas crusades that the senior pastor has led all over the world. His works of power manifested there were so amazing. By the prayer of the senior pastor, demons were driven away, and the lame man walked, and the blind received sight, and so on. The power that took place through the senior pastor is a series of surprises enough to leave us open-mouthed. It was really amazing, and I could feel in my heart the works of power and trust the words of the senior pastor more. I attended the Mammin Summer Retreat twice. The first time I was when I attended the 2017 summer retreat. I received the prayer of the senior pastor who prayed from the stage, and my left ear was opened. So I prepared for the summer retreat in 2018 with all my heart. I believed in works of the power to be revealed through Pastor Sujin Lee in the space of the shepherd. I attended various worship services, including Sunday worship service and Friday all-night service, and listened to his messages more carefully. Without missing one day, I attended Daniel prayer meetings and prayed fervently. In 2018, I attended the Manmin Summer Retreat and received Pastor Sujin Lee's prayer. When I received her prayer, I felt shaking in my body. When I received a prayer saying Amen loudly, I felt something like a vibration in my right ear, and then I heard a sound. It was so wonderful, and I was thankful that I could hear the sound with both ears. So, when Reverend Sujin Lee appeared at the campfire, I could hear the cheers of the members surrounding me very vividly. I could hear firecrackers popping, and the harmony of all the sounds was so touching that I could not express it in words. I was thrilled in my whole body. It was a very happy time. Before I was healed, I could not hear any sounds from my surroundings, such as the voice of my parents or the sounds of car horns. But now that I've been healed, I can hear the sounds even with my earphone, and I can hear all the sounds around me, such as people's voices, motorcycle sounds, and even the sound of a spoon hitting on the table. My sister also attended the summer retreat with me. Through the prayer of Pastor Sujin Lee, my sister's ears could open and hear. The works of my own experience of power was such that I could not keep my mouth shut. I would like to thank my dear senior pastor and Pastor Sujin Lee, and give thanks to Pastor Jonghun Ji for sign language interpretation. I will never forget this love. I will try to evangelize and convey the heart of the shepherd. Thank you very much for the shepherd who will lead me to the New Jerusalem. What I have been doing in plain language is that I send caregivers to hospitals. For example, if a patient is hospitalized, his or her family calls our association and requests that we send a caregiver because they all have to work.
간병인들을 채용할 때는 이제 신체가 첫째는 건강해야
When we hire caregivers, they must be in good health first. They need a health checkup. The reason why they need it is that many of the patients have weak immunity. So if my caregivers suffer from diseases, cold, coughing, or a runny nose, patients are vulnerable. For the sole reason that they should care for patients, not to pass on their infections to them, I had never sent caregivers with a cold, and do not send them even when they are coughing. There are more than 100 caregivers. Suddenly, the phone call came from the hospital. They said, They were at the hospital and asked where I was. So I asked, what's wrong with you? They said the caregiver was in the fourth stage of active tuberculosis. How could you be so irresponsible to send a caregiver with fourth stage of tuberculosis? They spoke harshly to me. The hospital got overturned. So they asked me how to fix it and to take To talk with my boss, the caregiver had exhibited the symptoms of a cold. So he got checkups four times at the hospital. The results of all four tests showed that he had a cold. By the way, he got a diagnosis from the director of the doctors, not from other doctors. Despite all of that, they did not know why he was so sick. I cannot be stopped by human strength. It cannot be. The activity rate is very high, and for the first stage, the infection rate is weak. But for stage four, the rate is so much higher. For example, if the infection happened, we would lose our business with that hospital. It would be over enough, though we had a written contract, and we would have to compensate the hospital for all the medicines. It will be rumored that it happened because of our association. It could become a very serious situation. I was worried about what to do, but I had the shepherd's prayer. So after the Sunday worship service, I went to receive Pastor Sujin Lee's prayer. When she prayed for me earnestly with the heart of love and with the senior pastor's heart, my heart became peaceful. After I received her prayer, I went to work on Monday, and the hospital nursing director called me. She was worried about it and asked me, but I answered her with, do not worry. I attended church very faithfully. Nothing will happen because I received deeply prayer. She said everyone who came to the hospital room would undergo a checkup, but there was a patient who had had close contact with a caregiver on a one-on-one basis for 4 days and three nights. They checked this old man first, but the old man was clean. That means we do not need to talk anymore about it. But no one was infected. After that, I did not talk on the phone with the nursing director at the hospital, but I was told by my boss that she was so thankful that it had worked out so well. And then it was a great trial of blessing. The hospital that had contracted for over a year ran only one room. So our income was not that high. But the incident involved other works, so it made us a double income. Since then, we contracted with other hospitals in Hong Song City and received more blessings. We have been blessed with many contracts with hospitals nationwide. A lot of good caregivers are coming in. First of all, my boss is really trusting me now, after all of this happened. Even if I say a word, I think he talks about it in a way to show respect to me. Director Lee Ye-ok has always decided from the customer's point of view, making the patient's recovery a first priority, and being considerate of caregivers and even the family's feelings. I think that she is a positively necessary person for the Caregivers Association. As I went through this incident, I deeply felt that there is a limit in what people can do. This incident has helped me help my faith to grow. I will become Deacon Ye-ok Lee, who comes forth as a fruit of joy to the senior pastor. I had many questions about the Old Testament and the New Testament of the Bible, so I tried to find the answer here and there, but nobody gave me the right answer. I've even thought, this is just a life as a Christian. It's because I wanted to know more, because I'm from a Hindu background. However, I attended the Delhi Mamin Church in India and witnessed many things that happened in the Bible. I've come to know the answers to many of the questions I had before, as well as the deep things that I could not imagine and that no one could know and preach. On December 3, 2018, I had a severe pain and had to go to the hospital. A doctor at the hospital did an ultrasonography, which showed stones in my kidney. The pain was so severe that I could not sit or lie down, so I moved here and there and screamed, and I could not urinate because of the extreme pain, and I just endured it. I felt a lot of pressure every time I went to the bathroom. Urine started to stagnate in the kidney, and I got hydronephrosis. As a result, my kidneys got swollen, and this also caused my stomach to swell. Pain also continued. As a wife, I really felt pain in my heart. I had to see my husband screaming and rolling around because of the pain. My husband could not eat and not even drink water. All he was doing was screaming. Pastor John Sang-hee Kim prayed for me with a handkerchief of power and asked Pastor Sujin Lee to pray for me on December 9th. On that day, after Pastor Sujin Lee's prayer, I could spend the day without pain. But strangely, the pain came back the next day. As a result, I found myself having something to repent of when I look back on my life. Through this incident, I realized that I was given a time of blessing looking back on my life. I realized what I should do and how I should fulfill my duty and how I should obey the word during this period when the shepherd is not present. I also repented of my own pride, frameworks, and self-righteousness. On December 26th, I went back to the hospital. The doctor who saw my test result told me that the kidney stones had gone down to the urethra. The doctor said that the stone was very large, 8 millimeter in size. The stone was not only very large, but also very rigid. I attended New Year's service and listened very carefully to Pastor Sujin Lee's message in order to be healed. It was an opportunity to look back on myself and repent. I once again received Pastor Shujin Lee's prayer by faith. After receiving the prayer, I went to the toilet to urinate. And while urinating, the stone came out without any pain. On January 16th, I received a checkup at the hospital again. The doctor who saw the test result was very surprised and told me there was nothing wrong with me. The doctor said there was no problem with my kidney, no hydronephroses, no problem in the urine. Now I can eat and run well, sit down and relax. I can feel free to do everything. So far, I've been doing well without any problems. And the results of the test shows that there is no problem. This is a tremendous blessing God has given me and the Shepherd's Space. Thank you so much for Pastor Shujin Lee's prayer. I'm very much looking forward to the Divine Healing Meeting that Pastor Shujin Lee will lead during the last week's Friday night service of each month. Numerous works of the Holy Spirit will unfold before our eyes. This is the evidence that God is with us and our senior pastor and works through Pastor Shujin Lee. That's why I give heal. I got healed here in Delhi also. It's something I experienced in person and cannot deny. Reverend Shujin Lee is leading us with the senior pastor's heart, just as he did. He also teaches us with the perspective from which the senior pastor sees. She is praying for us on behalf of the senior pastor, so we can receive answers. Thank you, Father God, for healing me. I'm also thankful to the shepherd who prayed for me in your heart. Thank you for spreading the space of the shepherd to me. Father God, Lord, Pastor Shujin Lee, thank you. I love you. On December 16th, 2018, from then on, I had a dull headache. And before that, I had cramps in my legs and felt popped in the back of my head. So the blood pressure present patients said they felt stiff in the back of my head. I had that feeling, but when I check up blood pressure, it was normal. The pain started so badly on December 18th. They say that they felt like the shingling racking out bones. As for me, I felt like it pulls from the earlobe to the head. I cannot express the pain with words. I was so sick, my heart so pounded, and I felt like the intestine swung down all the way and melted slowly. I went to the hospital emergency room, and a doctor came and diagnosed me with the shingles. And then he said, "You stay in the hospital for a few days, and I will check up again." It is said that if it goes wrong and spreads into the ears, it can cause blindness. I received the senior pastor's recorded prayer for the sick several times at night. It went up to the head, but the lesion on the head was not seen. When others have blisters on the neck and head, the wound is just red. But for me, I had this kind of wound that seemed like something yellow mixed with pus. So I thought, oh, I was so evil. I had this kind of dirty byproduct, something in my heart. So I went on to think that I had some difficulties in flesh and spirit last December. When someone told me something, I should have understood it, but I did not do so. And because I thought it in line with my way of thinking, it hurt. And then I really did not like anyone. If I did wrong, then I didn't think I was wrong. I blamed others for it. Crying before the Father, I always justified me by saying, I'm not like this. However, as the pain was repeated from this shingles, I completely realized myself like, Father, I stretch my hands to Thee. And I really realized just now that it was all my fault. I felt too much of my Father's love. I got a prayer in the middle aisles on the main sanctuary. So when all members shook hands, I thought, if I go down now, I can receive prayer. Then I went down from the second floor and went to Senior Pastor Soojin Lee in line. She prayed earnestly. And then, I did not really feel pain. On January 4th, our brothers decided to meet. I said, I have shingles and my face is not so good to see my family members. So, if I am cured, I will come. On the evening of January 4th, while I had a shower, I found scabs coming off easily. The scar is gone at that time. I prayed today, and then the scar became better. This shingles is a disease for others, but it's a blessing to me. I did it for souls, and I did this also for souls. When I centered all things on me, I could not get the answer. But this time, when the shingles came and I laid me down, it came from all my problems. I had a lot of evil and desire to boast. When someone told me, I had to understand it. But my face hardened and there was no love. Also, we Chinese usually has a strong accent. Especially, we Yeonbyeon city's people have a stronger accent, and I'm so when I pray, all people avoid me and say they cannot pray nearby. I kept praying to the Father that I have to fix this talking accent. It was my continual prayer title to keep my speaking tone soft. Along with this shingles, I've got all problems solved. To think about it, when I tried to raise my voice, but it went up only to some extent. My district leader told me, Deaconess, your voice is soft. You have a soft voice of prayer. Our Father, thank you so much. Thank you, I love you.
아버지 하나님께 속한 권능.
Power belongs to Father God. Power is to show an invisible God. When we go to heaven, we can meet God. But power can have people seem like seeing or meeting God on this earth. When we show this great and wonderful power to a great number of people, they can open their hearts to believe in the true God. To manifest this power, the senior pastor is filling up the justice in the current flow. We also know that there is justice to be filled with faith and truth on our side. After you have passed all this course, you will see God's work that will make all things work together for good. Father God who heals, Father God who answers, today may all members blessed with the healings at the Divine Healing Meeting led by Pastor Soojin Lee, the chairperson of Pastors Association, as well as answered to the wishes of your heart. We give all thanks and glory to God, who is with Munmin in amazing works of power.